Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thanks for convening this hearing on an important topic. So that last exchange was pretty enlightening, I think. The fact that you have two major corporations now pointing fingers at each other, and that's exactly what was just happening, shows a couple things. There's something wrong with these chemicals. That's an acknowledgement implicitly in that finger pointing that we just saw. And secondly, both companies know that there's a significant amount of legal liability and accompanying financial liability associated with these chemicals and how they were handled, and everybody's trying to get in front of that, I can see. I want to come back for a moment, Ms. Rutherford, to your testimony previously about the Responsible Science Policy Coalition, which I understand 3M is a member of or has helped to fund. And they have concluded among various studies they've done, quote, the weight of scientific evidence does not show that PFOA or PFOS cause health effects in humans. And you were asked about that, whether you agree with that or you don't agree with that. And I think you said you do agree with it.
Congressman, that's correct. I do agree with that statement.
Talk to me about that. How can you agree with this statement after all of the testimony that's come forward in the litigation and otherwise, that there are no health effects in humans from PFOA or PFAS? I just want to get into your head for a second, because on its face, it seems to me that that goes against the weight of the evidence, testimony, documents that have been presented for years when it comes to the impact of those chemicals.
Congressman, if I may.
Yeah, go ahead.
Again, it is the complete understanding of how the testing is done, the analytics, the approach to understanding this. I do appreciate that links and associations are indicated in those scientific studies. However, every study I've read, and I've read many, many of these studies, calls for additional work because there are a lot of inconsistencies in the data. Establishing a human health impact is a very complex thing. And
you know that back in, I guess, 1981, there was a memorandum inside 3M saying that as a precautionary measure, approximately 25 women of childbearing potential have received job reassignments at the 3M Decatur plant, so they will not be exposed to a type of fluorochemical that can cause birth defects in rats. So I guess, are you saying, well, it causes birth defects in rats, but that's not conclusive as to human effects? Nevertheless, there was a reassignment of 25 childbearing women. Are you aware of that testimony and document?
Congressman, I am indeed aware of that testimony and that study. What I'd like to share with you is I felt that that was a measure of very strong responsibility on our part. There was a study conducted in which we observed some of these birth defects. In what we found also, though, is that this was an inaccurate study. The way the fetus was dissected was not repeatable. We shared these information with the EPA, and the way we discovered that, Congressman, is that it showed up in the control group. The same issue that was found in the exposed population of the animals showed up in the control group with no exposure. So we were that showed and
something else. So on the one hand, I mean, I get your point here. You're trying to put a context around that particular information, and that's fair to point. But there's a lot of other information and evidence that has come forward, which really belies the statement and the conclusion that was reached by this Responsible Science Policy Coalition, which, as far as I can tell, is just a whitewash operation. I mean, it's sort of, you know, everybody's going to be okay coalition, but I don't think that there's good science behind that from what we've seen. The fact of the matter is the chemical industry has a tremendous amount of power, influence, resources, and they have deployed that for decades against the interests of the average person out there. They've done it with lobbyists, they've done it with campaign contributions, they've done it by buying studies that then masquerade as science, and this continues to go on. We have a responsibility here to push back against that, and we're not gonna give up until we've done that. I appreciate your coming here today, but this is the beginning of a continuing inquiry into the harmful effects of these chemicals. And with that, I yield back.